Hey everybody, Dr. Eli Lieber here. And today I'm going to walk you through one of very quantitative displays in Dedoose. This is the descriptor field by descriptor field chart. And so essentially what we're doing here is a crosstab analysis comparing across two different categorical variables. So I've selected sex here as my one variable, so we see males and females, and then TRI total group. And what that is the technology readiness index scale is designed to assess how amenable people are to adopting new technologies and then characteristics of those that fall out across the spectrum. And what we've done is taken that score from a study that we did, break it into four groups so we could do an analysis like this one. So what we're looking for here is basically whether or not, or the question we're asking is whether or not there is some association between these two variables in terms of how these subgroups fall out across the distribution of the other that we wouldn't expect necessarily by chance. So this is a traditional crosstab analysis, and what we've done is calculate the chi-square statistic for that. And so you can see down here in the lower left corner of the panel, we see that we have a chi-square score of 104.67 with 3 degrees of freedom. And without looking at a table of critical values, which you can see if you click this little question mark, I can tell you that that is a whoppingly significant result. So what that would be telling us from a quantitative perspective is that there's some difference in the way males or females fall out across this distribution on the technology readiness scale. And you know, just eyeballing this, we can see that it looks like the males as a distribution across that spectrum look like they're skewing a little bit towards the higher end, and females towards the other end or more flat. So that's what we're learning from a statistical perspective. And then we can go out and report that in our publications or other output. But one of the things that Dedoose is all about is beginning to facilitate digging a little bit deeper. And so all of these visuals are linked to the underlying data. So if we're interested in for a moment exploring what's happening with this female group who are in the very high end of technology readiness, then we can go ahead and click through that bar, look at the underlying qualitative data, see those excerpts, how they're coded, and just scroll through that so we can really get a sense of what's happening behind that visual display with those quantitative results. So what else do I want to tell you here? So from a very mixed methods perspective, this is an example of how Dedoose facilitates that process of moving from your data from the more quantitative end of it. These are the number of cases that are within each of these demographic groups across the qualitative, and how we can move back and forth as we start to explore our research questions. So there's other little details about this going on that we can just look at briefly if we want to look at counts of excerpts, which we actually have displayed here, versus descriptors or the number of cases. We can toggle that. And then by clicking this linked checkbox up here, what we're doing is we're looking at only those cases from the quant perspective, right? Because these analyses are just on numbers, a number of cases that we actually have qualitative data linked to. So in Dedoose, your descriptor set is that very quantitative type of data set that we have traditionally in spreadsheets. And then that information is linked to all of your qualitative media, documents, videos, and all of that, so that we can do the kinds of things as we explore our research questions, moving all around. So hope this is a helpful video. Plenty of other resources out there in our Learning Center on YouTube. So we'll see you out there, and great research to you.